What's up, challengers? Welcome to the gym. My name is Gym Leader Gio, and this is the GBA Season 5, Week 8 Battle of the San Francisco Giantes versus the Cincinnati Loudreds. I want to apologize from the get-go for this video coming out so late. There was a big scheduling conflict between me and Mulvone, the coach of the Cincinnati Loudreds, and it resulted in the game having to be delayed for our sanity's sake, because otherwise there would have been a lot of complex things going on. If you're curious about the team that I brought for this battle, please check out the locker room, the video that went up immediately prior to this video, and we'll go over all the sets. As you can see on the left side of the screen, I am bringing Latias, Vaporeon, Entei, Mega Pinsir, Blissey, and Ditto. And on the right, I have his team, and we're going to adjust that based on what he actually ends up bringing. So, let's turn this to a random music number, even though none of us can hear it because the music is silenced. And we're gonna hit battle start, and I'm gonna bring my battle box, and let's see what he ended up bringing. Let's see. So he didn't bring the Zangoose, that's good. It looks like he's bringing a lot of his defensive mon to try and wall through some of my team. So he did end up bringing the Weavile, as expected. He did not bring the Typhlosion, he did not bring the Noivern. He did bring the Mega Manectric. He didn't bring the Landorus. Interesting. I thought for sure he was going to bring Lando. He didn't bring Azelf either, which is a really good thing. He did bring Gastrodon. He did bring Gallade. He did bring Fortress. And he did bring Duskmoor. So, a couple of things. I don't know that I expected him to bring Gallade. Gallade is a good bring. Gallade is a good bring. I got to give him that. I did prepare for it. But I also, at the same time, I don't know, it's weird. It's got a good chance of getting one kill, but not a good chance of doing too much to me. So looking at this, seeing that he doesn't have the Azelf lead, Mega Manectric is probably a very good potential lead for him. So I could lead with Ditto to scout the Manectric set, but I don't really need to, just to kind of see what it's got on it. But I think what I would rather do is lead with Vaporeon. That way, if he leads with Mega Manectric, I can immediately switch into Ditto to take the incoming Volt Switch, which I would anticipate he does. So let's do that. If he opts to lead with the Fortress, I can just go for a Scald on it. If he opts to lead with the Weavile, that's an ideal lead matchup for me because I am not holding an item on Vaporeon. So he won't be able to knock it off for much damage at all. So I lead with the Vaporeon, and he is going to lead with Manectric. Okay. So, yeah. As expected, not a great lead matchup for me, obviously. But also as expected, my switch into Remix should be okay unless he opts to go straight away for the Overheat, which would be a ballsy prediction on his part. But I think he's just going to Mega Evolve and go straight away for the Volt Switch here. And that's going to result in Remix getting a boost. So let's see what he does opt to go for here. We see the Mega Evolution. If he sees right through my game plan and goes straight for an Overheat here, I'm going to be a little disappointed. He gets an Intimidate off. That's fine. He does go for the Volt Switch. I do get the Lightning Rod off. Okay, so now we're looking at a regular Manectric that is both plus one speed and plus one special attack. So, given that, we're gonna do a quick calculation here. Okay, so, pulling up those, we see he has Hidden Power, Thunderbolt, and Flamethrower, and Volt Switch, obviously. So, I can Volt Switch on him, as I will outspeed him. I could go for the Flamethrower here. And at plus one, it will do a good amount. It'll do almost as much to him as he will do to me. Oh, actually, I'm modest too. So I'll do 59 to 70 to him with this attack right now. I think it's worth it. And I'm just gonna go for it here. He's gonna stay in. It looks like we're gonna exchange flamethrowers, and this is gonna do so much. That's a crit. My goodness. Okay, he should do a lot less to me. As he does, about 50%. His Manectric is almost dead after that attack. And I outspeed it. So he scouted to see if I'm scarfed at the plus one attack. Oh man, that's good. So his best bet here is probably to switch into Gastrodon, who will resist this and give me the opportunity to kind of scout what he is. Manectric will go down if he opts to switch out and give me the opportunity to set up rocks later. Then I can kill him on the in switch, but I think I just go for the flamethrower here, see if he tries to preserve it. I think he will. Yeah, he's probably gonna go into Gastrodon here. I could have made a really offensive switch, but I didn't want to risk that. So we'll go for the flamethrower here and do really nothing, no damage at all. And we see the lefties. Now, if he's physically defensive, the flamethrower would do 19 to 22. That's fair. It's fair to assume that he's a physically defensive Gastrodon. Now, a couple of things I could do here. The best, I think, would be to switch into Eggington. Yeah, I switch into Eggington here, I think. Anticipating maybe an Earth Power, potentially a Toxic, and then I go for Stealth Rocks, ideally. Or I could go for the Toxic. He goes for a Toxic. He does still have his Rapid Spinner. It's worth noting. He does still have that. I don't see why he would stay in with Gastrodon here. I'm gonna opt to Stealth Rock here. I think he's switching. He does switch, probably into the Fortress. Predicting a Toxic or a Stealth Rock. Yes, he does go into Fortress. I get rocks up here. Now, he could go, he could be a Spike Setter set. So I could switch into Ditto to see if that's the case. I could switch straight into Decisions, scare out the Fortress. I could go Zoolander. I have a lot of options. I really do. Given the current situation with Mega Manectric being so low, I could also potentially switch into Cuddles on the expected Rapid Spin or Hazards of his own and start setting up, I could set up a Swords Dance, which would put him in a pretty bad spot because Gastrodon cannot do a whole lot against that. The Weavile could come in and Ice Shard me, and an Ice Shard from a Weavile will not kill Mega Pinsir. Quick attack at plus two should. I'm gonna go aggressive here. I'm gonna switch into Cuddles. I think he's gonna go for the Rapid Spin. No, he's gonna go straight away for the Volt Switch. That was a ballsy move on his part. I anticipate the Gastrodon. Gastrodon can pack Ancient Power. And I can hit him for 58 to 69 with my set, if assuming he's max physically defensive. because I am an adamant set. He opts to send in Duskmar. Okay. Duskmar can definitely take a hit. He's almost certainly going to go for a burn here. Could be a burn, could be an infestation. Could be a sneak attack also. Shadow sneak, I should say. His stab doesn't hit Eggington. He could be a trick variety. So that would be interesting for me to come in with Remix and scout that. I could come into decisions if I'm predicting the Willow. What does he have that he could hit Entei with? He could pack Earthquake. He could. And Sacred Fire won't do too much. I'd like to keep Entei around for the Weavile. Zoolander is one of my physical walls, so I think it would be pretty safe to go into Zoolander. If he does opt to burn, I do have Heal Bell. I can start trying to play around with him. There's no way he's going to break through Vaporeon. He is a physical wall for me. He does opt to go for the Willow. So I could have gone into Entei there, but I feel like this was a better play for me. Now he could switch into Gastrodon. I could wish here, which would allow me to pass on to pretty much anyone I wanted. I could go for the Heal Bell to remove the burn and kind of see what he wants to do, which I think is going to be my play. Yeah, I'm going to Heal Bell here just to get rid of the burn. He's going to withdraw, so I scare out Dusknoir. He's going to go into Fortress. How much damage can a fortress do to me? We just saw lefties, so he's not rocking some curious max special attack volt switch set or something. Or maybe he is. Maybe he is doing that. Vaporeon, my physically defensive set versus a fortress. Let's just play this game. 252 special attack. A 252 special attack modest volt switch is going to hit me for 28. So, I could wish over to my, to Remix right now. Wish over to Remix. Because I'm anticipating he goes for a rapid spin here and then a volt switch. If I go into Entei, I won't take much from the rapid spin. His recourse is to switch into Gastrodon, who currently doesn't really have any damage on him. I'm going to go for the Scald here. Put some damage on Fortress, maybe get a burn off on it. That does a lot of damage. If I get the burn, no, he goes for the rapid spin, unfortunately. Now, I predict a volt switch. And I predict he uses that volt switch to get into Mega Manectric. which is an easy switch to Eggington all every day of the week. If I stay in and go for the Scald, there is a chance he switches into Gastrodon, but that doesn't really do much for me except that it gives him Storm Drain. So he does have two options here. Gastrodon doesn't really... I mean, I don't want to be boosting its special attack. That's true. I think I wish here. So that's what I'm gonna do. I think he Volt Switches. I think I wish. He might opt to layer up a Stealth Rock of his own. No, he goes for the Volt Switch. So we've seen Volt Switch and Rapid Spin on this guy. That's pretty good damage. I should have realized if he was going to Volt Switch, I would have outsped him. Gallade comes in. Okay, now, this is one of the things we have prepped for. Gallade can hit me for 64%, I believe, with a close combat, which is his strongest stab. Let's go, let's assume he's Adamant. Let's assume max special attack. And you know what? Just for the heck of it, let's assume Choice Band. 68% to 80%. He could very well kill me with an attack this turn if he goes for a close combat. I'm going to protect. I don't know if he bulk ups. That's not great. If he bulk ups, I have to sack something, and then come in with Remix. I think he just goes for the close combat, but I... If he outspeeds me and goes for close combat, and I die, then I can come in and revenge him. That said, if he's going for close combat, I four times resist it with Cuddles. I don't think he's Adamant Choice Band, though. I'm going Cuddles. This is a ballsy play, but if he's got an attack for me, it's probably going to be a fighting one. It's probably going to be close combat or bulk up. It's a sub. Shoot. Sub bulk up? This guy does learn Rock Slide, and I really, really doubt he doesn't have Rock Slide on him. Sub on the Gallade, probably stab. Let's do this instead. Now that we know he's sub, let's switch into the red one. Because we know he's not, We know he's not Choice Banded. He has an Ice Punch for me. Shoot, that's gonna hit the red one super effective also, and it's gonna just about... Freeze me! He gets the freeze on the red one, okay. It's gonna be one of those weeks, huh? Leftovers on Gallade, that means with the Ice Punch, I'm gonna go into Zoolander here. Anticipating another Ice Punch. Zoolander can take this thing on. Going for another Ice Punch, and I can heal Belvis off. Thank goodness that one didn't freeze. Actually, it wouldn't have mattered. It just would have forced me to go for Scald the next turn instead. Instead, I'm going to go for Wish. He does have Bulk Up. Does have bulk up, so This may mean, if I let him get too many bulk ups here, it may mean something has to go down. I'm gonna go for a scald. Should it break? Scald against Gallade. It should break his sub, unless he has very, very high investment. So I'm gonna click scald here. He's gonna go for a drain punch. Doesn't do too much at plus one. I should be able to wish stall him out a little bit, get through some of the, get through his substitutes. Please break it. Oh, it took damage for it, didn't even break it. Ugh, this is bad. I'm clicking heal bell here as he clicks bulk up again. Click wish. He's just going all the way up. Going for scald again here. He's gonna opt for a drain punch. 172. Is that a crit? No, he just hit for that hard. That's impressive. Now Zoolander is my primary switch in for Weavile here. I do predict he's gonna go for a sub here. He might just want to get the kill on Zoolander, which I might have to let him do. He's at plus three now. Oof, this is bad. Against another Gallade. Man, I never should have switched out in the first place. This is problematic. He might just want to opt to kill the Zoolander here. I think I need to click wish. He does opt to go for the sub instead. What do I have to do here? Because I will lose a drain punching war against this Gallade. Ice punch would be the hardest hitting move I can do. Who don't I need? I need at least one thing for this Weavile. If I die here, if I let Zoolander die here, I get nothing. I'm gonna switch into remix. I think I can survive the drain punch, depending on this guy's investment. And with his boosts. Oh, I don't. Shoot, he's behind a sub. Oh, well, I suppose Remix was the least important member, but I forgot that you don't. Just a bad play on my part. Okay, I think something needs to get sacked to ensure that his substitute gets broken. Quick attack should break the sub. Come in with decisions when Cuddles dies. I mean, maybe the red one is the next person. All right, so we're gonna go into the red one and we're gonna click Draco to break the sub. Pretty sure he's gonna hit Ice Punch, but the sub needs to go down. Too bad I wasn't breaking them with one scald each time, but that'll be okay. Now, let's see. Is there a situation where he would survive a return from a Mega Pinsir? Yes. If he's max HP, max defense at +3, oh no, I'm animate though. He can survive a return, even from a Mega Pinsir. Not looking great with Ditto. Ditto and Latias down. Decisions could come in, and I could go for a burn. That might be the best shot. Let's go decisions. Let's either scare this thing out or let's get it burned. I know I'm not gonna kill with this. I do know that. But there's a good chance it burns. And it keeps it lower health and not behind a sub, and then I can come in with Mega Pinsir afterwards and follow up. Mega Pinsir is able to do a lot to most of his team. Obviously, it's not gonna... Oh, I really need to burn here. I did so little damage, and I don't burn. Drain Punch should take me out, and he gets all that health back, and I didn't burn. Okay, I lose, I guess. That freeze. Ugh. Yeah, that's a loss because Mega Evolve return. And hope he doesn't have defense investment. That it's just HP and attack. He still has a chance to live, even if that's the case. Man, that burn would have been nice. Regular Pinsir does outspeed regular Gallade. I'm assuming also that he doesn't have speed investment. If he does outspeed me, then he doesn't have the defense investment. Things are not going my way today, guys. I mean, the Ditto switch was my bad, but the freeze was kind of huge. I think he calc'd that I'm Jolly. I'm gonna really hope he doesn't have max defense investment and that this takes him out right now. It does! Okay, we're back in this. Now that meant I could have gone into that instead of sacking. Yeah, there were several Pokemon I didn't necessarily need to sack in order to have this situation come to fruition, but that's okay. Mega Manectric, Weavile. So luckily I did hold on to Vaporeon, who is my Weavile switch-in. Because he has to go for Icicle Crash here to try and take me out. Icicle Crash being the only thing that would take me out. Ice Shard would not successfully take me out. Return would take him out, but Quick Attack would not. Zoolander is a little bit low. Still has that Gastrodon with Storm Drain, so I need Cuddles to take that thing on. Eggington can also take it on. Zoolander is maybe not the most useful, but the problem is... Alright, here's the situation. I don't know what Weavile's held item is right now. Vaporeon was designed to take on this Weavile. An Adamant Choice Banded knockoff does 35 to 41. An Icicle Crash does 22 to 27. That's Adamant Choice Banded. Oh, shoot. I stayed in. Because I ran out of time. Frick, he missed? Did he miss the attack just now? Wow, Lady Luck. Pulling it back for me. Oh my goodness, he missed an Icicle Crash. I can't feel that bad. I've missed two Sacred Fires, which are 95 accuracy attacks. Wow, I cannot believe that just happened. I cannot believe he just missed an Icicle Crash. Wow. Fortress is in here now. Fully defensive Fortress. Can you even take? It looks like he can. He could go for a Volt Switch here. But I think I could just go for a Swords Dance. And then I think I take the game away here. So let's go for the Swords Dance. What is he? Oh, he has Toxic, maybe? Stealth Rock. I think he's maybe upset about that miss. Again, I don't want to say too much because you did get a freeze, bud. So, hacks. I'm really sorry about the miss. I really am. Especially given that it wasn't my intention to do what I did. But hey, that's the way it works out sometimes. I could get greedy and go for another one. Another one. Who else can take at plus two? I don't think anyone can take anything anymore. Let's not get greedy. Let's go for return here. He's going to withdraw Fortress in order to do what? Sack Manectric? Oh, he wants to get a minus one off on me. That's okay. Yeah, that's pretty smart, I guess. But he is losing his opportunities to take this thing on. Dusknoir. Again, I don't know what this Dusknoir does. I don't know its set. What I have calced is that the most it could do to me is a choice banded ice punch for 70 to 84%. Does it? Because I'm pretty sure I looked this up, and I don't think Duskmoor learns a rock type attack outside of Hidden Power Rock. No, it does. It learns. Did I look this up earlier? It learns Rock Slide and Rock Tomb. Well, that'll definitely take me out. It's probably too risky. Wait, is it? He could pain split. I might not be able to one-hit KO it, especially if it's defensive. If it's defensive, I certainly can't one-hit KO it. At plus one, even? I think he's got the rock type attack. I'm gonna go into Eggington. I think he's got a rock type attack on this thing. If he doesn't, then I goof big time. Willow, so he just wanted to burn it. He still got the fortress. I can wish around on things. I could go for the toxic here. I think he's switching into the fortress. He might. So all he wanted to do was go for the... Ah, that's interesting. Stealth Rock, how much is that going to help me? Probably not a whole lot. Let's go toxic. I think he's switching into fortress, probably. But there's a chance he stays in, reveals other attacks that he might have. If he's a defensive set, it's possible that he's like Will-O-Wisp with Infestation. Will-O-Wisp, Infestation, maybe Pain Split. And I'm not sure, Shadow Sneak maybe? If he had the rock type move, he would have gone for it there. In retrospect, I probably could have stayed in, but I don't think it was worth the risk that he could have one-shot. And then I would have had to gone into Vaporeon and played a weird Scald game. I didn't want to do that. I didn't want to turn it into this situation. I hope it's not... It is the fortress. Shoot. So the toxic was a waste. Unfortunate. He could hazard stack me here. That's very possible that that's what he does right now, that he hazard stacks. Because we've seen Rapid Spin, Stealth Rock, and Volt Switch. Maybe he has Explosion. Maybe Gyro Ball. If he has Explosion, it would suit him well to try and take out this Eggington sooner rather than later. Because that's the thing, I don't want this to turn into a stall match. Unfortunately, all of our offensive mon are gone except for Mega Pinsir. And I'm not sure what he has to take on Eggington. I'm gonna go for Wish, let's see what he's got. Volt Switch. Gets a crit, goes back to Andrew. back into Duskmourne. So here's the thing. He could switch back again into the fortress, but that's not really netting him any. There's no purpose to that. I think he's gonna do it though. I'm gonna click Stealth Rock. I think he's going for a tie. I think he's just trying to work around maybe my PP a little bit here. It would be nice to toxic this. Shoot, you know what, now that I think about it, now that he's seen the wish, he might think I want to pass that onto something else. He might double Willow. It's gotten to the point of the game where it's pretty much matchup versus matchup here. I hope he makes his turns pretty quick. If he doesn't, I may fast forward this part of the video. This is such a weird battle. I really did have my back against the wall with the Weavile still alive and having lost Entei. I think if I'd switched into... I still don't know what his item was. If it was Choice Bandit, it would have been... I would have had a problem. I really hope he's not. He's really taking a long time. He could be stalling. He's gonna withdraw. He's gonna send out Fortress again. He could go for Rapid Spin. He could go for the Volt Switch. I'm gonna click Wish. I think he clicks Rapid Spin, and then I think he clicks Volt Switch. If he's truly trying to stall this match out, he's gonna start going for Stealth Rock. He shouldn't have to think too long about this. Come on, Andrew. You got this, buddy. I'm going for Wish here because I think one turn extra is the play. I think he Rapid Spins, then he Volt Switches, and on the turn that he Volt Switches, I'm going to click Toxic to try and hit that Duskmourne on the in switch. I don't want to be in with Blissey anymore, but if I switch at the wrong time and get hit by a Volt Switch from the fortress and rocks damage on the in switch, there is a chance that Pinsir goes down. I go for the wish, he goes for the Rapid Spin. Oh, I'm faster than him, so if he is gonna Volt Switch, I can't toxic him. I went for the wish there. I should be okay to go into Vaporeon. Let's go for Stealth Rocks here instead. Because I think he's going to Volt Switch here. Rock Slide. That's the final move. So he was predicting the switch there into, he finally revealed it. He was predicting the switch into Mega Pinsir. Let's go Zoolander here. Rock Slide, Volt Switch, Rapid Spin, and Stealth Rock. He could double up on the Rock Slide. I'm bringing in Vaporeon here because... I'd like him to be in a situation where he's safe to get a little more HP up. And because the Scald will break up the mundanity of these last few turns. I wonder how different this game would have been if he hadn't frozen me. I wonder. Or if instead of going into Entei and trying to burn him, I had just gone into Pinsir and banked on the lack of defensive investments. He really is taking a long time to choose these turns. He goes for Rapid Spin. Fortress. Vaporeon. Let's put us at level 50 and see how much this Volt Switch is gonna do. Shouldn't be able to kill me unless he has a lot of... No, even then. A modest 252 Special Attack Volt Switch won't even do 81 damage. So I can click... Wish, as he clicks Volt Switch, probably goes into the Gastrodon, at which point I can Protect on Zoolander. And start making some moves. If it does have to come down to a timeout, and I really, really hope it does not. I really hope it doesn't. If it does, I will win... because I have three Pokemon and more HP on the three Pokemon, because that's eventually what will happen. That's how the math is calculated on a tie. Blissey alone probably has more HP than all of his Mon combined, because Fortress's HP stat is 75. If he has max HP without wasted investment, that's 181. He does go for the Volt Switch. I should be able to take this unless it's a crit. I take that just fine, and it wasn't a crit, and the crit wouldn't have mattered anyway because it wouldn't have killed me. I can Protect on this next turn. Duskmore, interesting. Well, we Protect to get that wish. Got a little more of this guy's moveset. It's weird. Maybe I shouldn't have switched out of that Pinsir, because now I have next to no chance to switch it in on anything. Between the Rock Slide on the Fortress, the chance to burn on a Scald from the Gastrodon, and the chance to burn on a Willow, I'm not safe to switch it in again. If that Fortress has attack investment against Mega Pinsir, how much will Rock Slide do? Yeah, if it's adamant with attack investment, it'll kill me. That's funny, because he had that opportunity earlier. He was in against me, and I went for the, let's see. I'm thinking he's gonna go for the Willow. No, he goes for Earthquake. That's not gonna do much to me. I'm gonna click Wish. Just because I want to stay ahead of the game here. I don't have leftovers, so I can't just abuse hitting Protect for a cute amount of extra HP. I need to be able to I need to stay on top of it. I need to be preemptive in when I'm popping my heals. And even though it might be obvious that I'll go for Scald the turn after that, I just think Blissey is such a safe switch into Gastrodon, and I can pop off a Toxic on it. At this point, I do think it's going to go to time, and I think that will result in Giantes winning because I have more HP. I don't want it to do this. I really honestly need an opportunity where I can go for an attack safely. And that shouldn't take that long, but it is a multi-turn process. I'm clicking my moves quickly here, guys. I'm trying to make this fast. Trying to make this go quickly, but it is a bit stally. I imagine this is really, really frustrating Andrew right now. And I apologize for that, my friend. He's gonna withdraw. Anticipating a Scald, maybe? Yeah, it looks like it. We're gonna go Eggington here. There was this situation I envisioned before this match started that I figured Gastrodon would be alive at the end, and so would Zoolander, and I kept saying to myself, should I bring Toxic instead of Protect or Heal Bell? And I'm glad I didn't, because both of those have been pretty important moves for me, or will be, potentially. The Heal Bell, because Zoolander, and maybe if there's a situation in which I switch around, get Pinsir in, and he gets burned, it might be useful. But let's see. Toxic. Ice Beam. Okay. Full HP Eggington in against the Gastrodon. The Gastrodon could switch. Look, here's the thing. At any given moment, if I predict the switch right, I could bring in Pinsir. But if I do predict wrong and Pinsir dies, I literally lose because it becomes a 2-3 instead of a 3-3. Right now, I'm winning. I'm winning this game right now. So honestly, I think I exchange a Toxic with this man. No, he's going to switch back into Fortress, probably. Yep. Because he's slower than me, I can't wait for him to Volt Switch and do it again. I just got. And I don't have Seismic Toss. How does he know I don't have Seismic Toss? I'm gonna click Stealth Rock. Goodness me. He may be trying to minimize differential, which I cannot blame him. I can't blame him for not wanting to wait this out as long as it can go. And he's got to keep every attack he can possibly do. I kind of see his thought process here. Against Vaporeon, his opportunity was try and kill the Vaporeon with that Earthquake. But now, it's don't ever let me switch in to Pinsir. Don't ever let me do it. Now he could go for Volt Switch here. I think I'm gonna click Wish, and I could pass that off to Vaporeon, or if I really want to get ballsy, I could pass that off pass it off to Mega Pinsir. One thing I could calculate is how much damage this Rock Slide is doing to see if Mega Pinsir could live it. So we've got a Blissey. Bold, max everything. You can go for the Rapid Spin, 331 down to 317. Oh, 331. Hit me for 14 with a Rapid Spin. Which is less damage than the minimum damage could be dealt if he was adamant with no attack investment. If he has no investment, but is adamant, 14 again is the minimum roll. So let's just say it. Let's just say he's adamant. Now let's go Mega Pinsir. I have some HP investment, I think. 141. Not really. Rock Slide still has the potential to do 71%. So if he does hit me on the switch, then I do go down. So Wish is up. I go Zoolander here. Shore up Zoolander's HP a little bit. See, here's the situation. This is exactly why I was saying it would have been nice to have both Toxic and goes to the Rock Slide. Again, not trying to create a situation in which it's not safe. He gets a crit in which it's not safe for Pinsir to come in. But unfortunately, because of the way this situation has unfolded, I can never... Blissey being faster than Fortress means he can always just hard switch or volt switch to avoid ever having to get any of his other mons toxic or ever letting... I'm going to double into Eggington. I think he's going to switch. I think he's going to volt switch into Gastrodon. So I'm going to switch into Eggington. So I think he switches into Gastrodon right now. Oh, he hard switches. Oh yeah, because he would get outsped. There's Gastrodon. Now on the off chance that he doesn't hard switch here, I have to click Toxic. But I think he hard switches right back into the Fortress. I'm doing everything I can here, guys. I'm doing everything I can here to try and make this not a 3-3. But if I wanted to do that, if I wanted to end this game 3-0, I had to have stayed in with Pinsir and gone for two returns and hoped that a plus one return from an adamant Pinsir 2-hit KO after the burn on the second turn against the Duskmoor. That was the only option I had there. It sucks because I know it seems like I'm the one doing the stalling because I'm not the one doing the attacks, but because of the way he's switching, which is very intelligent switching. He's playing it very safe. Clicks Rock Slide. At this point, I think we've figured each other's mind out. He knows that I'm never gonna just switch in Pinsir, knowing that Fortress is there and can put the hurt on him. Especially because Pinsir's at full health, And without reliable recovery, it's going to be hard for him to, rock slide to keep the pincer out. It's smart. He's playing really smart. I wish here, and then I'll protect. He's finally making his turns quickly now. He made that one instantly. I think he just spams... Oh, he spammed rapid spin that time. Okay. The goal here is end the game just as a wish goes off so that Eggington is at full HP. He didn't make this move quick. Well, I am sorry with the way this match ended, guys. I'm sorry that you had to wait for so long just to see this happen. I'm gonna go for the rock slide again here. The wish is gonna go off. We hit wish again. His best bet here, I mean, my best bet would have been to let the timer run. His best bet is to click rock slide and then let the timer run so that I don't get the wish back. I could have clicked protect and then let the timer run. I don't think it'll matter. With 361 HP left, I don't think it matters. Goes to the rapid spin. Yeah, it wasn't really his best play because I'll get most of that health back, all of it back from the lefties. And so everyone else at max health. Zoolander, yep. This is the best possible position I could end this game with. Clicking protect here. And winning based on max HP differential. Meaning it's a 3-3 victory for the Giantes, I'm pretty sure. I just want to see that screen. 2-1. Timeout. He is not going to be pleased with me. He is not. He is not. I defeated Andrew. Okay, guys. I am very, very sorry for this video. Going up late for it being so long. Just everything about this week has just been an utter nightmare. I never want to ever see this happen ever again. That Gellade was a good bring. It was a very good bring. I was prepared for it. I've seen him run bulk up sets in the past, and I would have been fine in my situation without that freeze, because I could have... If he hadn't gone for the Ice Punch there, he'd gone for something. Well, I mean, that would have changed everything. It doesn't matter. I don't want to split the... This is a game of chance. We all know it. He missed an Icicle Crash. He froze me in a situation that wouldn't have ever let Gallade get to plus 3. He never would even would have gotten to plus 1. I would have got Cuddles in. I would have killed something that turn, switched out, and the game would have continued. That freeze allowed him, because of how I had to... play around it, he ended up getting to plus 3 and getting 3 kills out of that situation, which wouldn't have happened without the freeze. So is it sad that he missed the Icicle Crash that potentially could have killed Mega Pinsir and won him the game? Yes, but I would have been, it would have been 5-6 with him, a Gallade that was about to go down or force a dangerous switch for him, and he probably would have lost if he had not gotten that freeze anyway. So if we're going to play the hacks game, I'm really sorry it ever had to happen, guys, and I'm sorry you had to wait so long for this atrocious mess. This is honestly an atrocity of a battle, and I'm sorry to present it to you guys. But don't worry, because next week we're going up against Old Man Tup and the Pittsburgh Piratas, and that one's, I'm hoping, going to be a lot better. As always, my name is Jim Leader Geo. You guys are the challengers. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys next time.